Hello, Pastor Steve Waldron, New Life Pentecostal Church, Albany, Georgia. We're so thankful you're here with us today. We're going to be looking at a fascinating book. It's the Apocrypha, but not, it's like an Apocrypha you've never seen. It's like a merger of the Apocrypha and the Forgotten Books of Eden and the Lost Books of the Bible. It's kind of cool. And some of it is in a new translation, the LSV translation, the Literal Standard Version. It's kind of a big book. It's over 400 pages. Let's see. Printed in Columbia, South Carolina. Yeah, it's 491 pages. I'll let you look on the inside. Now, it's not large print, and it's because it fits so much in here. Now, you might be asking, what is the Literal Standard Version? I've done a review, but it was when it was first coming out. I think I did the review before it came out. But it's basically a revision of Young's Literal Translation, which is one of the few Textus Receptus Bibles out there, actually. They do use the Dead Sea Scrolls, the Septuagint, and the Alexandrian text when they feel they need to, when the, as they say, the evidence is incontrovertible. So let's take a look on the inside, and I want to read a little bit of this introduction. The Deuterocanon, more commonly known as Apocrypha or Hidden, is the collection of writings which sandwich between the Old and New Testament, like in the King James Version, the original. These books are considered by some Christian denominations to be canonical or semi-canonical. While Protestants largely reject the books as spurious or even heretical, the Roman and Orthodox churches accept them as canonical. It may be wise to recognize historic Christianity has held more of a middle ground, including by reformers such as Martin Luther and early Catholic writers like Jerome. There's always been a distinction between proto-canonical books of the Bible and the deuterocanonical, or the second canon. The former being nearly universally attested to as God-breathed by the church, and the latter often questioned for their canonicity. So, I know like Martin Luther, I was reading something they had in the front here by Martin Luther earlier that I thought was interesting. While it's unwise to hold the apocryphal Deuterocanon to the same God-breathed standard as the standard 66 books of the Bible, we hold as Martin Luther did. This is it, not one quote. To their value as possibly true and good to read, but unverified. And now it's got something in quotes. Maybe this is Martin Luther. Apocrypha that are books which are not considered equal to the Holy Scriptures, but are useful and good to read. Now, here's what's in here, because it's the complete Apocrypha with Enoch, and many of you, because you tell me you do, believe that Enoch is inspired. The Ethiopian church has. I wish I had the time to do a verse-by-verse commentary, because it is clearly heretical. Jasher, which I enjoy reading, the book of Jasher, and Jubilees, which is fascinating. But you know, Jasher and Jubilees mentioned in the Old Testament. Some think Enoch was quoted in the New Testament. Some think that it was just Enoch saying and not the book of Enoch. But anyhow, so it's got like additions to the Bible. So let's go through this. The Universal Deuterocanon or Second Canon. Tobit, Judith, Wisdom, Sirach, Baruch, 1 Maccabees, 2 Maccabees. Then the Eastern Orthodox Deuterocanon, 1 Esdras, 3 Maccabees, 4 Maccabees, and the prayer of Manasseh, that evil king that repented. The Ethiopian Orthodox Deuterocanon, 2 Esdras, Enoch, and Jubilees. Jewish legend, Jasher, and then it depends on which Jasher. And additions to the Bible, Esther, Psalm 151, and Daniel. So it's got it broken down into the Universal Deuterocanon and all of this. So it's pretty interesting, and you can pick this up. This is done by Covenant Christian Coalition. You can pick this up on Amazon, very well done. I really like the graphics. Forget how much it is. It's maybe 18, 19, 20 bucks, something like that. Might can get it cheaper somewhere else. And so, again, many of you are into Apocrypha. I've been currently reading the Apocrypha for a while now. I just want to. to be able to answer questions. So God bless you. Thank you for watching. Please click subscribe. Watch our playlist. Love for you to join us every day. And we have sermons, Sunday school lessons, adult Sunday school, all kinds of stuff on here. Preaching, teaching. We want to reach the world with the gospel. God bless you in Jesus' name.